told. They said that the artist's life should be dangerous and full of traps. Let's see it. Me?
To be an artist is not a burden or something difficult, but a privilege. It's a commonplace or a common perception to say that the artist's lives should be twisted, confused, hard, or dark. Instead, I claim the right to say that it's a spectacular life. My name is Ciprian Paleologu. I'm a Romanian contemporary artist based in Bucharest, and I teach at the National University of Arts perspective, geometrical composition, and anamorphosis, the enigmatical and esoterical slice of arts. An artist must always be fit. It takes more than a pandemic context with an infinity of waves to stop me from my project. This unusual time, for most of the people, is not a barrier to me. The art studio is my genius brain, fitness and spa with 24/7 schedule. I'm a lean, mean art machine. And speaking about the area where I work, it is imperative to say that I'm placed in a Bermuda Triangle between three different creation spaces. Let me guide you around them. The first one is my classical art studio from the Romanian Artists Association in the city center, a small place. Before it, I had different studios location in the industrial places near Bucharest. The main characteristic of these spots was that each time an important amount of works invade the scene, making a little bit difficult to sail between working space or storage. The second area, Laborna Gallery, it's an unusual contemporary art item. Founded by me in 2013, it marks the professional individual artistic performance and show to the public the rough creation, preserving the artist or collector intimate activity with the intention to reveal a complete and complex archive. At the entrance of the gallery are my humans, a monumental installation, and in here mostly I work the outside artistic production, which needs more space and different conditions. And the third art studio space is more likely a laboratory, my own home. This is the place especially for project drawings, which occupy a lot of sketchbooks. All of these three creation points of the triangle mark an important path in my artistic development. In here I'm building up the flesh and structure of my most important art theory, the human project. I started this idea in the year 2000 when I was 24 years old and planned to reach 24 stages with a biennial period between each of them until I gonna have 70 years old. Such a huge project must be very simple in its anatomy in order to maintain the main aim. So, I divide it in two components, a premises called Homage to Helplessness, made of a series of displays able to identify and illustrate both individual and collective phenomenon, and a conclusion, building the Homodrome, an utopian mega-aggregate of human correction. And for this purpose, I'll set up an institute of corrective research. What made me start this sophisticated conceptual architecture, it's a huge amount of existential irony and the need to offer the world a token of consistency and stability. From the beginning, the moment zero, I knew and planned everything was going to happen in every stage in details. Each step of this project has its importance, and you can find more info on my website ciprianpaleologu.com or in the books published until now as Das Projekt Mensch one of the most complete printed radiography, edited in German, English and Romanian by Clartex Publishing. The 11th stage from the 24th series of the Human Project is my latest exhibition and took place at the National Museum of Contemporary Art from Bucharest in 2020 and the beginning of this year. Its name was And Then, a philosophical and visual perspective about the theory of the end. You can enjoy in some brief images, or let's say a personal tour inside. There are four drawings of 10 meters each, displayed as in traditional scrolls, with my humans attached on the infinity rope. Every one of these characters has a different way to mark himself, thinking of some kind of protection in this world or another. There are faces with exposed teeth, showing a strange expression. You never know if it's a laugh, a hideous making faces, a view of a huge effort or something else. As a reflection, three cubical forms are placed in the center with little humans attached as a mimesis of the big ones on the walls, in different geometrical configurations and with a simple message. There will always be an empty space at the end of the rope. These small items that you saw are the beginning of a series of conceptual human burdens jewelry. I started this program in between stage 11th and 12th. But what is in fact a human burden jewelry, HBG? This object is a conceptual jewelry, its pieces handmade, produced. In this moment, three types of jewelry are available: the ring, the necklace, and the bracelet. It represents a small human being figure on a rope, as the one presented in the 11th stage of the Human Project exhibited at the National Museum of Contemporary Art from Bucharest. Each jewelry comes with a contract certificate between the producer and the receiver, made like a folding drawing object on skin. This contract will remain in the possession of Ciprian Paleologu, and a copy shall be sent to the new burden jewelry owner. And now, how can you become the new owner of the human burden jewelry? You may ask. In order to receive one human burden jewelry, you have to give up, in exchange, one day of your life. This day will become the property of Ciprian Paleologu and his human project and can be used by the new owner in any ways, terms and purposes as he considers. This is a brief. More info as well as applying for a human burden jewelry can be made sending a private message on the following platform and inform us about your intention. The mail is ciprianpaleologu@yahoo.com. Instagram and Facebook account Ciprian Paleologu. Details about the entire process can be found also on the site ciprianpaleologu.com, HBG menu. So come on, don't be shy, give me a day of your life in exchange with a human burden jewelry and find immortality.